It's a little hard to say how unusual this is in the culture, in part because we get different strands of evidence. For example, Philo, down in Alexandria, roughly contemporary with Paul, says, we keep our women at home and pregnant. You know, I mean, he doesn't quite say that, but it's pretty close. Well, that would have come as news to Luke, who describes a pregnant Mary making a trek to see her cousin Elizabeth in the other side of the country, and he doesn't say anyone's with her or guarding her or protecting her. It's kind of an odd thing to do. Luke also has stories about women in the circle around Jesus. The evidence varies, and the evidence varies depending on where you are, what level of society you're in. I think Roman women, in general, we know that Roman women were better placed to do things, to head the home, to run the home, which was really to run a small enterprise, than Greek women were, who did not sit at dinner with men, for example. So it's very hard to generalize. I do think we have to be careful about not making early Christians sound as if they're such an odd phenomenon, right? However, I do think it is unusual, and one of the reasons I think it is unusual and they experienced it that way is that we also see pretty early on evidence of some pushback. By the time you get to the end of the first century, in a letter from Clement in Rome to Corinth, he comments on how, you know, you've done a good job of making sure your women don't get too uppity. So we see the pushback early on against the roles of women.